President Yoweri Museveni has consoled the Lusanja Chitezi garbage slide victims that claimed the lives of 18 people by press time. On his X account, the president conveyed his condolences to the families of the people who died as a consequence of part of the rubbish heap at Chitezi peeling off. He, however, wondered who allowed people to live near such a potentially hazardous and dangerous heap. He directed the deputy IGG, Anne Muhaire, to expeditiously investigate the matter and furnish him with a report. On Friday night, garbage from the Chitezi landfill buried homes, animals, and some people inside their houses. By yesterday, it was suspected that more people are still buried in the garbage.
The earliest rescue mechanism were done, and the rescue was done by our residents, civilians, people are there voluntarily calling. They use the hose, spades among others, and their own hands to rescue those they rescued. So we believe that police needs the assistance of these people to identify the soft spots and where probably people are expected to be trapped under the sun. However, I also want to urge government and all concerned agencies, we need more machinery.
On Saturday, 10 people were retrieved alive before the break of dawn. Patrick Onyango, the Kampala Metropolitan spokesperson, said the survivors and the bodies were taken to Mulago Hospital and St. Stephen Hospital in Imperere. Irene Nakasita, the spokesperson of the Uganda Red Cross Society, said structures have already been set up to accommodate the displaced families.
We did not sleep. We actually slept here. We had to put up the necessary infrastructure to accommodate families that are displaced. So we set up tents here to support the males, the females, the children, and our tents can accommodate up to 1,000.
For me, as me, I think we shouldn't dump any more garbage here. Should look for another alternative place. That's what we are going to work on tomorrow. Because if we don't act quickly, still we are going to suffer for garbage in Kampala. Because where are we going to put it?
The president also directed the State House Comptroller to financially assist the families of those who died with 5 million shillings per person who died and 1 million shillings per person who was injured. Find more details of the tragedy in today's New Vision. Hundreds of believers from across the globe attended the consecration and enthronement of Reverend Canon Jacob Ateireho as the 6th Bishop of Bunyoro Kitara Diocese at St. Peter's Cathedral in Hoima City. This included the Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Dr. Stephen Samuel Kazimba Mgalu, together with more than 40 Anglican bishops, graced the event. Many government dignitaries, including members of parliament, were also in attendance.
Continue to work together and support your leadership for growth and spiritual nourishment to continue. You are not alone in the fight against poverty, gender-based violence, illiteracy, crime, environmental degradation, and so forth.
The government gifted the new bishop a Toyota Prado delivered by the Prime Minister Robina Nabanja.
To the new bishop, I congratulate you upon this spiritual achievement. Your appointment is a testament to your unwavering faith, dedication, and commitment to serving God and the people of Bunyoro Kitara.
The event was a culmination of 4 months of waiting since the House of Bishops elected Ateireho as the Bishop of the Diocese, replacing Samuel Kahuma, who announced his retirement after serving for 8 years. Until his election, the new bishop had been serving as the vicar of All Saints Town Parish in Hoima City. President Yoweri Museveni has reassured tenants that the government will always protect them against land grabbers. He said land issues are common because people refused to take the NRM advice on landlords and tenants. He made the remarks on Saturday while launching the Kalule Community Playground and commissioning the Kaguta Block at Excel Vocational Training Center in Kalule Parish, Nyimbo Sub-County in Luwero District. The president assured Luwero residents that no one is allowed to evict them from their land, even if they have a land title. He explained that if people use the NRM structures, like the LC system which the government put in place to protect people's interests, then the land issue would be dealt with accordingly.
Now, what my Muzukuru Adige is talking about the land issues, This is because people don't listen to the message of the NRM.
Museveni congratulated the founder of Excel Vocational Training Center, Haji Mwanje Shafik, for his contribution towards the education sector in the country.
And Shafik, Mwanje is a challenge to all of you because he's blind. But he has done so much. So the question is, if somebody who doesn't see can do all this, how about you who has got all the faculties? So therefore, you people of Luweero who are near the market here.
He also advised the people of Luweero to embrace wealth creation programs. The Minister of State for Higher Education, Dr. John Chrysostom Muyingo, thanked the President for his visionary leadership that has led to development in Luweero.